Welcome. In the previous module, we have left the large petroleum molecules trapped in the source rock. These molecules will leave the source rock and flow along permeable layers until they reach their final destination, the reservoir. We will now discuss the main processes driving these movements, namely buoyancy and capillary pressure. Buoyancy is the pressure exerted on a mass with a density different from that of the surrounding. It is directly proportional to the density difference between the two fluids and to the height of the moving fluid. How big are density differences? How strong is the buoyancy motor? The plots in the slide show the densities of oil and gas at a range of temperatures and pressures. The latter is proportional to depths. A first order message of these slides is that densities of oil and gas are substantially lower than that of water. This means that hydrocarbon will move upward. While moving upward, oil will become heavier and the density difference with water will decrease. The density of gas, on the contrary, decreases with depth, making movements of gas even more efficient. Flow of a fluid medium through a porous rock is resisted by capillary forces. The capillary pressure depends on chemical and physical interactions between the fluid and the surrounding medium and is inversely proportional to the diameter of the pores. The first step the hydrocarbon molecules will have to do is to get out of the source rock. We call this primary migration or expulsion. Primary migration will proceed slowly as pores are very small and the column of hydrocarbons very small. As soon as the hydrocarbons will enter the permeable rocks, they will travel much faster, with their movement being favored by much larger pores and an increasing hydrocarbon column. Following lines of a highest gradient, petroleum drops will move upward, eventually end up in the reservoir or, if the trap is not encountered, at the surface of the earth. How fast are hydrocarbons moving along the permeable layer towards the reservoir? For this purpose, we use Darcy's law, which describes the flow of a fluid through a porous medium driven by pressure differences. As you can see from the equation, flow is inversely proportional to viscosity, which means, for instance, that oil will flow more slowly than gas. On the other side, flow is directly proportional to the pressure difference and to the permeability. Viscosity and pressure differences can be measured. The big unknown is the permeability K. Permeability is defined as the ability of a fluid to flow through a body of rock. Predicting permeability values is not easy. If we look at the vertical axis of the plot in the slide, you see that permeabilities of different types of sands vary up to 10 orders of magnitude. The problem is made even more complicated by the fact that hydrocarbons, in their tens of kilometers long journey from the source rock to the reservoir, will travel across very different lithologies. The permeability of large bodies is of interest to us, not that of small samples we can measure in the laboratory. Predicting permeabilities in buried, inaccessible, large body rocks is very challenging.